There's like the lockbox, and then there's also this board with all these random letters. It looks hardcore. But if I go home tomorrow, like, I want to know I at least stepped up. And Charlie and I are like frontman guitar player, you know? Diamond Dave, Eddie Van Halen. It sucks to be like, yo, we lost. But I mean, I like to look at the world as a glass half full kind of vibe. They were like, don't even worry, y'all stepped up, which was awesome. So at this point, my strategy is to be myself, which is to just chill hard to make everybody laugh. So I'm just sitting there with the flint going hard at it. And I got it, and I lit fire, and I felt higher than rocking a sick show.
You did it, Ben.
My man.
I'm crying thinking about fire. Like, I didn't even cry over meeting Nicolas Cage.
High five, buddy, you did it.
Bring it in, dude. I was always the kid with so much energy. Teachers couldn't handle me. You know, I haven't been the sharpest tool in the shred my whole life, you know? I had a stutter and I had a lisp. So like, I was bullied, but I remember my dad had a guitar in his closet. I found it, the power of rock. The thing that helped me overcome my insecurities. I've played shows all over the world. I played big festivals and I did so many things that like, I think I blew my own mind.
Good job, Ben.
Thanks, dudes.
You kept at it.
But in my head, I feel like I am like still a little insecure kid. Who I am has always been in me, but I haven't trusted it. I don't know why I'm crying. I'm just like so high.
Keep the tears away from the fire, though.
For me, it was so important to get fire because it was so out of my element and comfort zone. Makes you feel like you can do anything. What a stupid way to pass time. And if I had done that in any other setting, everybody around me would be like, Ben, shut up. But here, everybody was like, yo, they're going for it. Listen, there's a bit of an unfair advantage because although I love Metallica, I'm not a stan for terrible albums. Charlie is an adorable goofball, and I love him for it. I'm having the most fun out here, you know? It's like, I would say even if I ever did Survivor again, I don't think the experience would be this dope because it's these people that are making it so enjoyable for me. Like Banu said, I didn't come to win $1 million, I came to win 1 million hearts. A little corny, but like when you're raw like that, it hits. You know what I'm saying? That's like an Oasis line for sure, okay? Everybody's got to draw rocks. The one white rock will go home.
No risk, no reward.
The blue rocks have a chance to compete for an advantage, but if they fail, they lose their vote at their next tribal council. You're given all these different shapes of blocks to form a perfect cube. You're like three little squares and then four or five big squares. The puzzle's fun. Problem is you're only given until the timer runs out. Immediately my mind is racing. How am I gonna sell this back at camp? Sup, gang? Even though I don't have a boat, I still have an advantage because the intel I get is out of control. I'm somebody that I think when in life you get given challenges, you can only mull about it for so long. So I'm not gonna sit and think about not having a boat. I'm gonna think about like, all right, how am I gonna strategize? You know, I hate lying, but I don't want to tell my tribe that I don't have a vote yet because the cracks haven't shown yet. But if somebody says they don't have a vote, they're easily going to be like, yo, person without a vote's got to be the one to go. Mariah, she cannot jump. I don't know if David Lee Roth would be proud of that one. You know what I'm saying? You know, I've been getting more depleted every day because the shelter of pain is not a condo or a luxury hotel room. But anytime you suffer is another opportunity to learn the depths of your mind. I'm really thankful for Charlie, and he's looking out for me. But like, you know, I have had some survival experiences. You ever been stuck in a van with the same six people for 2 months surviving off $3 of Taco Bell a day? It is not easy. Jem corners me. She's trying to get some information.
Cause she's got information.
You just know when you know.
She's holding the machete, so I grab the hammer, like, try to hold my space. She's like, go with your gut. And my gut is telling me Jem's playing at all costs, and if we keep her around, she's just gonna screw us at the next vote because she's so, like, it's chaos mode. And I know she's approached Tim because I saw it and I heard it. I'm just hoping we take Jem out. The problem is, nobody knows, I don't have a vote.
Me not having a vote, it definitely blows, but like Jem, she's kind of like made everybody feel a little bit on edge. She's on end game mode, but if you come into a game like this already thinking about the $1 million and you're not thinking about every step along the way, you're never gonna get there.
I don't want to throw anybody's name out from SIGA. I really want to go SIGA strong. But everybody keeps asking, yo, what's up with SIGA? You guys got to throw a name out there. After tribal, I wake up from a dream and panic mode like kicked in. I have this hysteria for about 50 seconds and have to calm down from it.
It was like a bit of a shock part of it.
Yeah.
I understood how nuts it was in the moment because I've had panic attacks before. It's like something I can't control. Thank God there were some nice people in the tribe and Kenzie was able to just calm me down. Kenzie held my hand, helped me make a fire, and she made me feel like it wasn't gonna be some kind of like, yo, Ben's being a freak show, back to like the sixth grade vibe. My biggest hope tonight is that I can convince the Yachty 3 and the Gun Hunter, or else I'm screwed. That simple. You know, like, Kenzie, she looked hesitant, but I don't have much to go on. I'm in a tough corner, but you can't go down not swinging. Would it suck to be taken out tonight? Sure. But it's like gambling. If you pulled this off, I would feel high the rest of the game. You know, in the words of the mighty Van Halen, time to go bottoms up. I lost my good friend at Tribal Council. There was this unnamed bromance happening, the gruesome twosome twins, me and Tim. And it kept me feeling sane during the game. It's funny to like cry over another dude. And I definitely think he was my rock, you know? Q doing that at Tribal was like, hey, I'm a coward and don't want to be at the bottom and reap the consequences of my actions, so please vote me out so I can look like I have a moral high ground even though I'm a total idiot. What Q pulled last night was a poser move, trying to act like a noble saint when really he just destroyed his own game. The plan to take out Tiff fell apart, and now we're in a position where we could take Hunter out. But I know if Hunter goes, I have more of a chance at winning something. Because he has crushed most of the challenges.
We have to make sure Kenzie's cool with it.
If you guys want me to talk to Kenzie, I will.
It presents like a golden platter. You only get like the T-Rex in Jurassic Park back in the cage one time, and we've already done that. I'm not trying to have a Jurassic Park sequel right now. I'm trying to get him out so the playing field is even. You know, Liz has a daughter at home. And when the Applebee's reward gets revealed, Liz very publicly states that this would make her feel like home.
That bourbon burger is what I get too.
And on top of that, the bourbon burger is her go-to menu item.
My anger is satisfying my hunger right
now. Yeah, my need for vengeance.
Like, how can you not feel for that? But I think Q is working from the bottom, so the only option he has is to rekindle his old alliances. But I think they would be idiots if they fell for this crap. If I were in their position, I'd be like, yo, let me get the Applebee's and still get Q out next. And I have been thinking about this vote. Q is a schemer and a bit of a bully, and I want him the hell out of here. But the argument for Tiff being the vote is that everybody knows Tiff has an idol, and the idol's more dangerous than Q at this point. Q is a heavy target we gotta get out of the game. But at the same time, Venus also does have to go. My reason for Venus having to go has nothing to do with her being a threat. She's just creating more and more chaos. She freaks out before every tribal, and she's always running around trying to pitch some crazy plan. And I'm sick of being around that, so I'd rather get her out first before we get out anybody else. Yo, for real, not lying, I was not supposed to write Kenzie's name down. I was supposed to write Venus's name down. And I just had a slip of the brain.
You literally told me you would never write my name and then, like, did.
Dude, I...
Like, that's like a big blunder, you know?
I'm at this point in the game where I haven't been sleeping, and I feel like I'm losing my mind. Kenzie has helped me with my night terrors. I genuinely blank, and you know what? I just didn't want there to be any tension. I can't... It's getting way harder for me to sleep. It's very obvious how weak I am these last couple of days. I'm waking up in the middle of the night.
Hold it together.
The first time I had a panic attack, it was very mental. You know, you're disoriented, you're in the jungle, you don't know what's going on.
It's getting hard for me to do this. You know, I messed up.
Now, the part that bothers me and it freaks me out is my body has a mind of its own. I had an experience camping when I was 18 that traumatized me. I woke up screaming irrationally, you know, thinking about college, thinking I'm gonna die. And it was very similar anxieties to what I've been going through in this game. I think every time has been the time to take out Q, but especially this time because there's only two votes left. And the only reason Q keeps avoiding getting voted is because Maria's convincing us all to use him as a number, which is really, oh, they're an alliance. How did we not put two and two together?
We're like the four court gestures taking down the king.
Yeah.
Finally.
Maria and Q think they've been running the show for a bit, but now everybody's trying to come together as one to take down the king and queen. It was so sick Kenzie picked me for the reward today, because in this game, you hope to make alliances, and then you make a real friend with a person like Kenzie. Like, how can you not feel grateful to Shred in a situation like this? On top of that, we're sitting in Fiji, overlooking one of the most epic landscapes of all time. It's such a vibe, it's like electric almost. I think we're all on the same page because the enemy is so common. Maria is a whole package threat. Multiple immunities, decimated people's gameplay, played an epic game of deception. So unless she finds an idol or pulls a blindside, Maria's done. At night, I don't know what happens. Some nights I have a reason why I freak out. But last night I had all the reason in the world to chill. You know, I had a reward, we got Maria out, but I had this hysteria and I have to calm down from it, and it takes a while. I thought I went into this game really having conquered some of my demons, but the big lesson for me in life is, how do you let go of trying to control what you can't? And how do you trust in yourself and believe in who you are, despite your fears? I don't show up for myself, I don't pay. But what if that was the whole journey of all my stress?
I think that's a beautiful lesson to learn.
Yeah. But at the same time, I feel very blessed because people show up for me. They believe in me.
Anti-anxiety hug. We got you, bro.
To me, it just comes down to, like, I went through it. I didn't quit. And thank God I had Kenzie and Charlie. I was so down on myself, and I could have quit when I was at my lowest. But I didn't. And for some reason, the determination just came out. And then I won immunity. It's so sick. 13-year-old me, who got made fun of for everything and told I wouldn't get anywhere. Who's gonna be able to tell me what now, dude? I'm so proud of myself. Nobody would call me a challenge beast. I was the kid they didn't pick for dodgeball, you know what I'm saying? Wearing this necklace as a Survivor fan, it's just like, damn, I did it. To hear Jeff just say, Ben's got it, like, that was crazy, you know? After all my panic attacks and all my fears, it's just a confirmation. When in doubt, if you rock out, it's all gonna work out. And then the weight of winning hit me. I'm in the final three, and this necklace allows me to pick who's gonna sit next to me and who's gonna go at it in fire. I have to think, who can I beat at this final three? So I feel like no matter what, it's a difficult thing. And some people need the money more than others. Some people are in different situations. She was like, I got money. I just want to make it further. I'm broke, you know? Like, I share a space with my parents. So to me, it just confirmed that I don't want her in the final three.
Yeah, well, I'm out. I'm last jury. I suck at fire. I can barely hold a knife. I hear my wrists.
Yeah. And on top of that, Liz has the most homies on the jury. She's the last person on Nabi. Because people didn't think she was a threat, now she's here.
Can I give you a hug?
Sure.
You don't want one, I get it.
So now the thing I gotta think about is who I'm gonna put up against Liz. I'm trying to figure out who I think has a better chance at beating Liz. That's what I'm talking about.
Dude, you crushed it.
Charlie's really good at fire. But the hardest part is Charlie's been my number one from day one. I love the kid. And the other side is Kenzie. She's been one of the best friends I made out here. And she's been my number one through my panic attacks. She's been a sweetheart.
There you go, Kenzie.
I don't know how I'm gonna lean one over the other.
Boom.
I have to think wisely. It's heavy, bro. I'm standing between a rock and a hard place. The best part about the final three morning is the feast. I'm chilling hard today, but tonight I have to give the performance of a lifetime. My game was a game of honesty built around being myself and relying on my social cards. Everybody called me a vibe person. Tonight is about showing that a vibe or chilling isn't about being one-dimensional. It's not me using it as a gimmick. It's about showing I played a hard game from day one.